I went back in and I fixed this, but I'm going to show you now how to use the clay buildup tool around the eye socket and how to get the welt around the eye and the indent on the bottom side, and then around the lip we'll do. So what I'm going to do is I want to make sure that symmetry is still turned on before we start. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do B on the keyboard for brush, C for clay, and B for clay buildup. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to give myself a decent brush. And I'm just going to start working in around the eye. Maybe a little bit bigger of a brush. Start working in around the eye. What we should do is mask off the actual eyeball itself so we don't mess with it too much. Okay. And now I'm just gonna work in this area around the eye. It's not. Yeah, maybe not do the eye. It's coming out kind of funky. So I'm just going to go all the way back to before we started. And I'm just going to kind of build up right here. I'm going to make this the tallest, the most material. And then as we go, I'll just do another one that's lighter. And you keep going lighter and lighter. And then you kind of blend in these areas a little bit right here. It'll make a big mountain in this area. Then we want to kind of keep working it till you got it relatively blended in the big mountain right here. And then we can take our smoothing tool and just lightly do it with the flow that we were going with in the beginning. Just lightly. Now if you look, we kind of got a mountain right here, and I'm kind of missing a little bit right here, so I'll add some more, kind of fade it out, lightly hold shift and fix that, and now I'm going to add some more again in this area. And then we'll smooth it out by holding shift and lightly tapping. Push really hard on back here to try to get this little area blended out. And now we have the eye socket. And now we can go and hold alt. To subtract, and we can just go underneath here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to just make the whole area evenly subtracted that I want, kind of like in a big area. And what I'm gonna do so this is the whole area that I want to indent, and it's all kind of just about the same distance subtracted. Make it kind of in here a little bit, And then what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna hold Alt again, and I'm just gonna go a little bit deeper, and just take it like a staircase down. Just a little bit deeper right here. And then I'm gonna make it just a little bit more deeper right here. And kind of blend it in. And then we can kind of blend in the ridges over here. And we didn't really get this area in. Blend in that area. And then we can hold shift and just lightly smooth. This needs to kind of get fixed a little bit, so just gonna lightly, a little bit more heavy in the middle to fix that problem. Just using heavy pressure to shade now, make the brush a lot bigger. Some better shading going on in this area. Then you can see, if you change it like this, you can see exactly where you need to get into. Then I can shade it all back in. If you need to add material because it's a little bit too much, that's okay too. Just add a little bit of material. And then we can just shade it all back in. And now you have your indent for the eye socket. It's protruding up here and then indenting down here. And now we can start working on the lip. So the top lip, I'm just going to use the same brush size. I'm just going to lightly do this until I make a big ridge. Apply a lot of pressure, it's gonna do a lot, so that's why you kinda just wanna keep it to a minimum. Just very lightly, and then down here, kinda do a ball. Make sure you fill the middle of the ball. More work on the outsides than you do in the middle. The middle will build up. It's the outsides that you need to worry about. Of this ball, the outsides of the ball. Build up the lip a little bit more. And we can come back and just hold shift. And just lightly, very lightly. Very lightly. We can come back and build it up again. Build it up, smooth it down, build it up, smooth it down. Oop. And then yeah, perfect it like that. And then we're gonna go work on this bottom lip. So I'm gonna just kind of work in this area. Doing the same thing. Build up a lot of material right there. Make it a little bit thicker. Then I'm just gonna hold shift, smooth it out. Smooth it out. There you go. Should use that same principles for the rest. Perfect it. And yeah, that's how you do that. And if you want, you can even hold Alt and indent a little bit right here. And then lightly shade it in. So you get more Fact. If that's what you want, kind of looks bad, but. Okay, now with the forehead, to pull this forehead down. Actually, that's it for this video. We'll focus on that in the next video.